Of course, you are yourself a successful author. Can you tell us a little bit about that for people who haven't picked up a copy?
Yeah, it's right here. Cheesy plug. It's called How High the Moon. And yeah, it's my first novel. It actually comes out March 5th. And I'm really excited. It's a middle grade novel, historical fiction about a young girl in the segregated South of the 1940s. And it's kind of a coming of age story. Her dealing with being light skinned as opposed to her mother, who's brown skinned, and living up in Boston, not knowing who her father is and getting clues into that. And then also one of her good friends is based on the real character, the real person, George Stinney, who was wrongly convicted of murdering two young white girls. And that story is also in there as well. So it touches on how that affects all the rest of the community and our protagonist. And I think it's something that's actually still very relevant today.
As we look to the future, why do you think it is so vitally important that we look back to the more painful elements of our past?
I think if we face the ugliness of our past, particularly in America, there are some things that people don't want to look at, but we're not going to be able to heal the wounds that we are dealing with now. We're not going to be able to heal a lot of the racism and problems that we are having if we don't look at the past, face it straightforward, and make the changes that we need to, and really look at each other. I think that's something that a lot of people have a problem with, is wanting to face it because it's uncomfortable, but we need to.